Elbow bumps and other socially distanced greetings replaced handshakes for EU leaders in Brussels, their first summit in person since the start of the coronavirus pandemic in Europe. The EU Commission President, along with the leaders of France and Germany, wants to reach a deal on an $860 billion COVID recovery fund to help the bloc's battered economies.
Stakes couldn't be higher. If we do it right, we can overcome this crisis stronger and emerge stronger from the crisis. All the necessary pieces are on the table and a solution is possible.
Discussions are already fraught. Leaders are divided over borrowing such a vast sum of money from the financial markets and can't agree on whether it should be distributed as grants or loans.
Verhandlung. Deutschland wird sich einbringen.
The differences are still very, very large, and I cannot therefore predict whether we will be able to reach an agreement this time.
Some fiscally conservative countries, including the Netherlands, worry about shared debt. They prefer loans with conditions rather than grants.
What is very important to us is that countries reform. And if they want grants on top of loans, something we don't want actually, then you have to nail down very hard guarantees that reforms will be carried through.
The French President Emmanuel Macron urged leaders to show solidarity.
So here we are at this very particular European summit, the first to be held physically since the start of the coronavirus crisis, and one that will be entirely dedicated to the European recovery plan and the budget for the coming years. This is a moment of truth and ambition for Europe.
Macron says a failure by the EU to unite and help member states at a time of crisis could fuel anti-EU sentiment in the bloc and jeopardise its future. The talks are expected to continue for most of Saturday, but with so many differences and so much at stake, leaders may need even longer to reach a deal. Natacha Butler, Al Jazeera, Paris.